From Manhattan's Church of the Intercession, this is a special Christmas presentation from New York's very own PIX11, the 109th Clement Clarke Moore Candlelight Carol Service.
Hello everyone, I'm Kaity Tong. In 1822, New York native Clement Clarke Moore wrote a Christmas poem for his children, which he entitled, A Visit from St. Nicholas. Most people today know it by its opening line, "Twas the night before Christmas." This year, I am proud to be reading the poem here at the Church of the Intercession, continuing a tradition that has lasted for more than 100 years, followed by a candlelight procession to the author's tomb. But who was Clement Clarke Moore?
Clement Clarke Moore's life spanned between the Revolutionary War and the Civil War.
He's literally a child of the Revolution, and he's one of the first to grow up in the New Republic.
Moore's father was Benjamin Moore, a rector of Trinity Church, but is now chiefly remembered for having given the last rites to Alexander Hamilton on his deathbed. The younger Moore was born and lived in the family home known as the Chelsea House at roughly 420 West 23rd Street.
A high-class enclave, and it's the neighborhood today that we know of as Chelsea.
Moore graduated valedictorian from Columbia College, now the liberal arts arm of Columbia University.
He was a classic scholar of Greek and Latin and Hebrew.
But like many scholars of the time, it was not unusual for him to write verses. Christmas in Moore's pre-Civil War New York was not the same as what we know today. It was full of heavy drinking, excessive eating, and public rowdiness.
And so Moore was living through that period, looking to celebrate with his family, disturbed over the years by the growing rowdiness. And through this poem, in part, Christmas became more of a family idea.
Now, more than 150 years after his death, the writings of this scholar from an upper-class New York family continues to have an impact.
And we remember him not for the Greek, not for the Latin, not for the Hebrew, not for the Psalms, but for this poem.
The reading of the poem is a focal point of this event, but music has always played an important role in this beautiful service, and this year is no exception.
It's a Christmas event, so the music is to really get you in the Christmas spirit. I guarantee you that if you come to this service, you'll be singing the carols and ready to go home and get yourself ready for Christmas.
So this ensemble came to be, we were all former members of either the Boys Choir of Harlem or the Girls Choir of Harlem. And after all of us went to college and graduated, now with different degrees, we all decided just to come back and for the camaraderie to be an alumni group of singers. And we do it for fun. We're super excited to be here. We hope that you enjoy our performance.
To love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace.
Sweet.
Change shall he bring,
yes.
For the slave is our brother, and in his
Jesus,
name,
Jesus,
our brother,
Jesus,
great.
I'm the Reverend Rhonda Rubinson, and I'm the priest in charge here at the Church of the Intercession. Basically, the center of the service is the poem that Clement Clarke Moore wrote. It's a combination religious and secular service. We honor children on this night, so you'll see many children performing. We give children antlers and gifts and candy during the course of the service. And then we go down to Clement Clarke Moore's grave at the end of the service, after the reading of the poem. And honor him.
My name is Nam Schulman, and I'm a music teacher for the New York Institute for Special Education. Music has so many impacts for the students, and the most important is helping them to develop their self-esteem, that they can be confident and be very proud of themselves. Music brings joy to the students, and they are so happy to share their talents with audience at the Church of Intercession. I hope you enjoyed this marvelous performance.
En la música que tocó, en la pieza. We've been friends for a while, and when I found out that she was going to be singing at the church, as well as I was going to be, I was like, I have to do something with her. I've always wanted to sing with her.
Oh, really?
Oh, wait, I didn't tell you that? No.
What's special about the holidays to you?
So I know to, you know, a few people, it depends. It's like, oh, presents. No, it's not about that. It's about family, love, and the connections you build with people.
Intercession is one of the great parishes in the Diocese of New York. It is a wonderful space. We do bilingual services on a regular basis where that the two languages are combined in word and music. And we are working hard to keep this building open and alive for the community.
And this community comes all out for this wonderful service, as we see with these fantastic musical performances.
Feliz Navidad, prospero año, felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
The Young People's Choir of New York City is a multicultural children's choir made up of over 2,000 children here in New York City. It's very exciting. The children that are going to sing here at the service are coming from all over Washington Heights, the different schools in the neighborhood that we're living in here. And they're going to come together, 80 young people going to come and sing gorgeous music in this beautiful service. We're very honored to be here to celebrate the holidays with this amazing group of people from our community. I hope you enjoy the Young People's Chorus of New York City.
When the room is gloomy and its atmosphere has fallen,
The Uptown Brass plays pretty traditional brass quintet music. A lot of the pieces we'll be playing today are heard for generations. Playing here at the Clement Clarke Moore service is always fun. There's always great music. It's a great Christmas tradition.
Christmas to everyone. Happy Kwanzaa, happy Hanukkah, happy New Year. Everyone be blessed.
Church of the Intercession was founded in 1846 by Episcopalians John James Audubon and John R. Morwood in the Carmensville section of Manhattan, now known as Washington Heights. Initially, services were held in Morwood's home until the first building was completed in 1847. The congregation moved again in 1871, this time to a stone structure. The current sanctuary began construction in 1912 with the help of Trinity Church, which came to the rescue of a then financially struggling parish. Situated next to the Trinity Church Cemetery and designed by renowned architect Bertram Grosvenor Goodhue, the church is considered his Gothic Revival masterpiece and is also his eternal home.
Bertram Goodhue was one of the leading American architects of the time. He fell in love with this project. And it is told that he really put his heart and soul in the design of this building. And his architect friends designed this tomb for him. You can see there is a likeness of Goodhue. His head is resting on architect books. And then at his feet, there is the winged horse Pegasus, which is the symbol for architects.
Goodhue incorporated a variety of church styles, from English Perpendicular to Tudor. Among the many incredible examples of craftsmanship commissioned by builder Edward A. Weir is the high altar.
This altar has 1,563 pieces of stone that represents some portion of Christian history. The stone in the middle where the cross is, that stone is actually from Calvary. And on top of the altar, when the priest comes to bless at the beginning of the Mass, he kisses the stone from Calvary. So that is as close as he can be to the most sacred spot in Christendom, Calvary.
Steeped in history and revered as a beautiful work of art, the Church of the Intercession is now listed on the National Register of Historic Places and continues to serve Washington Heights' joyfully diverse community of faith.
A procession is a proclamation in motion, right? You're proclaiming something while you're moving, and usually singing while you're moving. Even though there is such a thing as a silent procession, we're going to be singing in all of our processions tonight. The first procession, the lesser procession, comes down the side aisles of the church. That's significant because we're moving away from the altar of the church. We're going to the back of the church, a place called the porch, which is the furthest point away from the altar in the entire church. We're singing, O come, Emmanuel, as we are moving down the side aisles. What we're doing is we're asking for God to come to us. We're pleading for God to come to us. We're waiting for Jesus to be born. And when we get to the back of the church, we read the gospel from Luke, where Jesus is born. Then we have our great procession, which is down the center of the church. And we essentially echo what the shepherds saw and heard that Christmas Eve. We sing Angels We Have Heard on High, and we sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing, which are the two songs the angels sang when Jesus was born. And we head towards the altar, which is, of course, symbolic of Jesus and Jesus' birth and then later his sacrifice.
Thank you. Christmas is very special. It really brings everyone together with food, gifts, prayers, church, as you know, they perform today. So it's very, very special.
It's a magical time. It's a wonderful poem. You know, you have somebody who creates this poem, a simple poem, and then a year later it starts to become famous, and then more famous after that. And you know, you have children for all this time, for close to 200 years, reading this poem, hearing the poem time after time again. We could say Clement Clarke Moore basically changes the holiday tradition, because prior to that, in the 18th century, 17th century, young children are celebrating St. Nicholas Day. So originally the poem's called A Visit from St. Nicholas, of course, and St. Nicholas tradition from a bishop on horseback with his servant Master Peter changes to that jolly old elf, still by the name of St. Nick, riding on a sleigh being pulled by 8 tiny reindeer. So you could say what we have as our modern Santa Claus today was pretty much created by Clement Clarke Moore.
Greetings to everyone here in the Church of the Intercession for our 109th annual Clement Clarke Moore celebration, or as we call it, Santa's New York layover. I'm Rhonda Rubinson, I'm the priest in charge here at Intercession, and on behalf of myself, our assistant priest, Father Luis Gomez, Deacon Luis Rivera, and all of our staff and parish, I'd like to welcome you to what we believe is New York's oldest Christmas tradition, a holiday reading of the classic poem, A Visit from St. Nicholas, better known as Twas the Night Before Christmas by Clement Clarke Moore. This year, our reader is someone who is familiar to many of us. She is often in our homes. Please welcome Kaity Tong, the weekend anchor of the Emmy Award-winning PIX11 News.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kaity. Thank you, Kaity, for agreeing to be our reader.
The first time I heard Twas the Night Before Christmas was when Mrs. Granger, my kindergarten teacher, read it to us in our class. And I didn't understand any of it, because I was a 5-year-old girl who had just come to the United States with my parents from China, an immigrant, and did not speak a single word of English. What's with the donder and the blitzen and the sugar plums? I was lost. But what I did get was that everybody was riveted, all my friends, all my classmates were really riveted. I loved the playful cadence of it. I knew there was drama, and the enthusiasm and the joy with which Mrs. Granger read us that poem, that I got. And later, of course, it became a part of my own Christmas tradition, which I passed on to my own family.
Everybody come up. Closer to me. This is great. Oh my goodness. You all look wonderful. Yeah, everybody sit down. Hello, everybody. Let me just say, I have never experienced a service like this. It is unique, so extraordinary, so moving. The performances, the music, all of you sitting out here with your antlers on. I've never seen anything like it, and I thank you so much for letting me be a part of this evening. Thank you so much. So, kids. Oh? Yeah? Okay. Oh, our little ones here. I love us. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I didn't hear you.
Yeah.
Are you having a good time?
Yeah.
Do you like my hat?
Yes!
All the right answers. So let's get started, shall we? All right. The Night Before Christmas by Clement C. Moore. Here we go. Uh-oh. Okay, here we go. All right. 'Twas the night before Christmas. Went all through the house. Not a creature was stirring. Not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. Stockings hung by the chimney. See? The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there rose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. When, what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With the little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen. That one's Comet. Has a name right on there. I'm not even kidding. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. Uh-oh, how am I doing? Not so good? This little one doesn't like the way I'm reading this. Oh, I'll bring it down. I'll bring it down a notch. As dry leaves before the wild hurricane fly when they meet with an obstacle mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. Oh, I lost part of my audience. Bye. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. Here he is. Do you notice he's not wearing a hat? What happened to a Santa hat? I'm wearing it. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses. His nose, like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. Ah, here's a good picture. What's he doing here? That's right, he's eating his cookies and milk. Is that what you do on Christmas Eve, some of you? Yes. Still doesn't have his hat. The stump of his pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. I love your smiles, thank you. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, hi, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. Mommy, where are you? Aw, it's almost done. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team, gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, as he drove out of sight, Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Yay, the end. You guys were a terrific audience. Thank you. Thank you so much. Merry Christmas to all of you.
Thank you, Kaity.
I've been coming since I was a little kid. I didn't come for many years. We used to have a party for the little, they used to have a party for us little kids when we go down to Clement Moore, and we'd come back and there would be little packages under the tree in the common room for us when we were little. Christmas means joy and happiness. It means something of the future. It's going to be great. It's a beautiful holiday. Really is.
Trinity Church Cemetery was part of a cemetery movement. Some people refer to them as garden cemeteries or ornamental cemeteries. A deliberate effort to make cemetery grounds much more inviting, places where you would want to spend your eternal rest, but also where you would be inclined to visit. They were also the blueprints, so to speak, for the parks that came later. We are in Upper Manhattan, specifically in Washington Heights. New arrivals are starting to refer to this area as Hamilton Heights, up to 155th Street. The land was bought in 1842. The first burials began in 1843, the following year. This is the only still active cemetery on Manhattan Island. John James Audubon is one of the more famous notables who are buried here. He died in 1851. He was a naturalist. He identified and painted and drew all of these wonderful birds of North America that many of us have grown up in school knowing because of his drawings. And this is how he made his fortune. John Jacob Astor, he was said to be the richest man in America when he died. He left a huge endowment which helped to establish a free circulating library, which has evolved into today's New York Public Library. There are a lot of Astors here, and certainly the key Astors, namely John Jacob Astor and John Jacob Astor IV, who died on the Titanic. The last New York City mayor to be interred in the ground is Edward I. Koch, who's buried in the easterly division of the cemetery. The cemetery really unfolds as a place to not only commemorate loved ones, but great events in American history and in New York history.
The last procession, the lantern procession, where we take the entire congregation and we cross the street and we go down to Clement Clarke Moore's grave on the other side of Broadway, is essentially going caroling. We're going outside and we're celebrating Jesus's birth and we're singing "O God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen," which is a typical, a very old English carol. St. Nicholas, of course, is the lead character in the poem, "Twas the Night Before Christmas," and he comes with elves. We'll be going down to the grave following the lights. We carry lanterns and we follow a path of tea lights, lanterns that are on the ground. And we go down to Clement Clarke Moore's grave and honor him there, and we sing the whole way. We've just laid the Eleanor Dixon Hawkins wreath on the tomb of Clement Clarke Moore. Let us pray. O God, whom saints and angels delight to worship in heaven, be ever present with the soul of your servant Clement Clarke Moore, who sought through the art of poetry to perfect the praise offered by your people on earth. Grant to him everlasting life and the radiance of your beauty in heaven, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Oh.
deck the halls with boughs of holly. Fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly. Fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel. Fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol. Fa la 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 la. See the blazing Yule before us. Fa la 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 la. Strike the harp and join the chorus. Fa la 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 la. Follow me in merry measure. Fa la 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 la. While I tell of Yuletide treasure. Fa la 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 la. Fast away the old year passes, fa la 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 la. Hail the new ye lads and lasses, fa la 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 la. Sing we joyous all together, fa la 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 la. Heedless of the wind and weather, fa la 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 la.